Case 1. When water or ice accumulates on the deck, there is increase in the weight of the ship just above the COG of the vessel. This results in the shift of COG upwards. Ice formation increases the KG of the vessel, lowering GM. Case 2. When a timber cargo on the deck absorbs water, this weight is normally added above the COG of the vessel and hence the COG shifts upwards. Here, due to water absorption by the timber cargo on the deck, there is an increase in the KG of the vessel. As a result, GM is lowered. When the ship is listed, if a tank is completely filled with a liquid, the liquid cannot be moved inside the tank and acts as a static weight. So, the center of gravity of the ship remains unchanged. The graphic shows the listed ship when the tank is filled with liquids. Assume that the ship floats at the same shaft with the same kg and with the tank partially filled. Now, if the ship lists, the liquid flows to the lower side, causing the g of the liquid to shift to G1. This results in the center of gravity of the ship G moving to G1. This effect is called the free surface effect. You have seen that when GM is positive, the ship is in stable equilibrium. When this GM is a large positive value, the ship is called a stiff vessel, whereas when the GM is a small positive value, the ship is called a tender vessel. A tender vessel has a large angle and period of roll, while stiff vessels have small angles and period of rolls.